సాయంత్రం వస్తారు కదా, రాత్రి రాత్రి కొట్టింది కదా, నీ అమ్మ టెన్షన్ పుట్టించారు కదా బాబు. ఫస్ట్ 3 వికెట్ ఎవరైతే
हेलो आल ऑफ यू जॉइन फास्ट. All of you join fast. Hello. So yesterday, we have discussed two problems on composite wall, and I also given the concept of combined intransfer. So that is, if you combine conduction intransfer as well as convection, there is overall heat transfer coefficient U. So yesterday derived that equation 1 by U is equal to 1 by H1 plus L by K plus 1 by H2 for a suitable given area A. 1 by U is equal to 1 by H1A, otherwise if you consider area 1 by H1A plus L by KA plus 1 by H2A. So if you consider two convective transfers, for example, if you consider a single wall and through the wall conduction heat transfer and two sides of the wall, one side of the wall is exposed to one convective environment and other side of the wall, if it is exposed to second convective environment, and there is so overall heat transfer coefficient to be calculated by considering first convection and conduction and second convection. So you have to calculate overall heat transfer coefficient. By using overall heat transfer coefficient, you can calculate heat transfer rate Q is equal to UA into delta T overall. Delta T overall, where Q is the heat transfer rate and U is the overall heat transfer coefficient, A is the area. Next, delta T overall. So what is the overall temperature drop? Overall, from initial temperature to final temperature. That may be in between one convection, one conduction, or one convection and conduction and second convection. So convection heat transfer. Like that, if the conduction and convection heat transfer are combined, or otherwise, if any heat transfer system, both are involved, both the modes of heat transfer, conduction as well as convection. So we have to calculate overall heat transfer coefficient U. But how do you calculate overall heat transfer coefficient U? That is equal to, so 1 by U is equal to 1 by H1A plus L by KA plus 1 by H2A. First one with respect to convective transfer, second one with respect to conduction, and third one with respect to convection. Like that, if two convections and one conduction are involved, you can calculate so your overall heat transfer coefficient by using the formula 1 by U is equal to 1 by H1 plus L by K plus 1 by H2. Otherwise, your overall heat transfer U is equal to 1 by H1 plus L by K plus 1 by H2 for a given area A, A not mentioned here. Otherwise, 1 by H1A plus L by KA plus 1 by H2A. And per unit Okay, sorry for the description. Sorry for the disturb. So there's some disturbance is there. Sorry for the disturbance. And so by combining conduction, convection heat transfer, so you can calculate convective heat transfer coefficient by using this formula, overall heat transfer coefficient. So by combine, this is through conduction within the block, plane wall conduction. Here left side one convection environment, right side other convection environment. So if you combine together conduction and convection, here left side one convection heat transfer within the given single material conduction heat transfer, here second medium either air or when cooling water, that is convective environment. And if you combine convection, conduction, again convection, and overall heat transfer coefficient U is equal to 1 by H1 plus L by K plus 1 by H2 for a given suitable area. If area is 1 per unit area, then you can calculate overall heat transfer coefficient U is equal to 1 by H1 plus L by K plus 1 by H2. What is H1? Convective heat transfer coefficient for this fluid, left side fluid. And what is L? The thickness of the material, solid material. What is K? Thermal conductivity of the material, solid material. Plus 1 by H2. What is H2? Convective heat transfer coefficient of the second fluid. Okay, na? So yesterday I given how to derive that overall heat transfer coefficient. Now we'll discuss one problem on this. A mild steel tank of wall thickness 12 mm contains water at 95 degrees centigrade. So left side convective heat transfer medium fluid is water, which is at a temperature of 95 degrees centigrade. Then the thermal conductivity of the mild steel tank material is mild steel. What is thermal conductivity? 50 watts per meter Kelvin, or otherwise you can sometimes in some textbooks he is giving the unit of thermal conductivity as watt per meter degree centigrade also. So either of the unit can be used, watt per meter Kelvin or watt per meter centigrade. So thermal conductivity is mild steel, MS is mild steel. That is the material of the tank, mild steel tank. 50 watt per meter Kelvin or degree centigrade. And the heat transfer coefficients for the inside and outside the tank are 2850 and 10 watts per meter square Kelvin or degree centigrade. 2850 and 10 watts per meter square degrees Kelvin respectively. So if the atmospheric temperature is 15 degrees centigrade, calculate the here H1 2850, H2 10 watt per meter square Kelvin, and atmospheric temperature, that is T2 15 degrees centigrade. Calculate for this configuration the rate of heat loss per meter square of the tank surface area. That is, you have to calculate heat transfer per unit area, rate of heat loss or heat transfer per unit area per meter square, and temperature of the outside surface of the tank. So outside surface tank temperature to be calculated. This is the problem. So a mild steel tank so here water is stored in this tank. This is a sectional view of the tank wall. So here water is stored, T1, or otherwise water of the hot fluid, hot water 95 degrees centigrade, water of the hot fluid, hot water 95 degrees centigrade. H1 convective heat transfer coefficient of the hot water that is available inside the tank. T1, so left side surface temperature of the wall. T2, right side surface temperature of the wall. This is the wall. And in the right side, there is a convective environment, outside air. What is the outside convective environment? Air. Having a temperature of 15 degrees centigrade. Having a temperature of 15 degrees centigrade. So here H1 given at 2850. H2 given at 10 watt per meter square Kelvin. H1 convective heat transfer coefficient at the for the hot water given as 2850 watt per meter square Kelvin. And for the second convective environment, that air, H2 given as 10 watt per meter square Kelvin. And temperature of the air, ambient air, 15 degrees centigrade. And you have T1, you have to calculate T2 here. What is asked to calculate? What is the heat transfer rate per unit area? That is to be calculated. And what is the temperature T2? That is to be calculated. And for that, you have to calculate T1 as well T2. But in the problem, you asked to calculate T2. If you want to calculate T2, first you have to calculate T1. Okay, na? Now, what is there here? The left side, convective heat transfer. And within the solid material, the tank mild steel material, tank material or wall of the tank. This material is mild steel. So through the mild steel, the conduction heat transfer. So temperature drop from 95 degrees to, this is a temperature profile. Temperature drop from 95 degrees centigrade to T1. Again, through this is first convection. Next, through material, mild steel material, heat transfer through conduction. Heat transfer through conduction. So temperature drop from T1 to T2. And again, that much heat is again transferred to what? Outside air. Then again, temperature drop from T2 to 15 degrees centigrade. T2 will be more than that of 15 degrees centigrade. So ambient air temperature 15 degrees centigrade. So this is the wall of the tank. And this is H1. Convective heat transfer coefficient. This is a convection heat transfer. So convective heat transfer coefficient for hot water. Convective heat transfer coefficient of the hot water. So this is the wall of the tank, which is manufactured with mild steel. Outside the tank, is exposed to ambient air, which is at a temperature of 15 degrees centigrade. And H2, convective heat transfer coefficient for the air, given as 10 watt per meter square Kelvin, whereas H1 given as, that is convective heat transfer coefficient for the fluid of hot water, given as 2850 watt per meter square Kelvin. The thickness of the material, thickness of the tank wall, L is equal to 12 mm. So, in order to calculate heat transfer rate, so how to calculate Q is equal to UA delta T overall. What is the delta T overall here? 95 degrees centigrade minus 15 degrees centigrade. Delta T overall temperature drop. That is from 95 degrees to 15 degrees centigrade. Okay, in between there are temperature T1 and T2. But overall temperature drop, 95 degrees centigrade to 15 degrees centigrade. That's why, how do you calculate heat transfer rate Q? Q is equal to UA into delta T overall. Delta T overall 95 minus 15. U, overall heat transfer coefficient. Area, this surface area. But it is not given in this problem. So surface area of the tank wall, this area. Surface area, this area. But not given. So for unit, per meter square, we have to calculate. So L is equal to 12 mm, thickness of the wall. So overall heat transfer coefficient, how do you calculate U? As already given yesterday, 1 by H1 plus L by K plus 1 by H2. That is equal to 1 by H1. That is convective heat transfer coefficient of the hot fluid. 1 by 2850 given. That is given in the problem. Plus L. What is L? Thickness of the material. That is 12 mm. So 12 divided by 1000, you'll get meters. Divided by K, that is 50. Thermal conductor of the mild steel. given as 50. That's why 12 by 1000 into 50. That is 12 by 50,000 plus 1 by H2. That is convective transfer coefficient of the outside environment. That is air ambient air. So that is given as 10 watt per meter square Kelvin. So 1 by 2850 plus 12 by 1000 by 50 into 1 by 50. If 50 into 1000, that's why 50,000. That's why 12 by 50,000 plus 1 by 10. That is 1 by this, if you simplify this one, 0.00035 plus 0.3024 plus 0.1. So then overall heat transfer coefficient U is equal to 1 by 0.10059. If you simplify, U overall heat transfer coefficient 9.94135 watt per meter square Kelvin or watt per meter square degree centigrade. So you can use either Kelvin scale or degree centigrade. So either of the units can be used. Generally we'll follow in the SI system watt per meter square Kelvin. So overall heat transfer coefficient by combining this convection, conduction and second convection heat transfer. So convection heat transfer here through the material in mild steel material, that is tank wall, conduction heat transfer, and after that heat is being given to outside ambient air, which is at a temperature of 15 degrees centigrade. So by combining the first convection, conduction and second convection, you'll be calculated. So you can calculate overall heat transfer coefficient by using this formula, 1 by H1 plus 1 L by K plus 1 by H2 for a given area A. Given area is one unit. So one unit area. So area one. So after calculating overall heat transfer coefficient, that is given calculated as U, overall heat transfer calculated as 9.94135 watt per meter square Kelvin. So heat transfer per unit area small q. So actually capital Q is called UA into delta T overall. Capital Q is called UA into delta T overall. But for unit area flux, heat flux, small q is equal to U into delta T overall, only. That is called U value, that is overall heat transfer coefficient. So just now we calculated 9.94135 into overall temperature drop, delta T overall, the 95 to 15 degrees. That's why 95 minus 15. So if you calculate, so heat transfer rate per unit area, small q, that heat flux. For unit area, you can calculate heat flux. Heat flux is capital Q by A, or heat transfer rate per unit area. So that will be, after calculation, that will be around 795.308 watt per meter square. So that's a unit area, but 1 meter square, one area for a unit area. So 795.308 watt per meter square. Okay, now that is the first bit. What is second bit? You have to calculate temperature T2. But how do you calculate temperature T2? How do you calculate temperature T2? So you can calculate either, if you want to calculate temperature T2, first you have to calculate T1. So how do you calculate T1? So from this, convective heat transfer, here convection heat transfer. How do you calculate convection heat transfer? So Q is equal to HA, that is H1A delta T. Delta T is temperature drop from 95 degrees centigrade to T1. That's why, so heat transfer per unit area, HA, area one. So heat transfer rate per unit area, small q. Heat transfer rate per unit area, small q, HA, A is equal to one meter square. H1, this one, you can H1. H1, you write H1 instead of H1, into 95 minus T1. So from this you can get T1. So from this 95 minus T1 is equal to Q by H. Q just now we calculated 795.308 divided by convective heat transfer, convective heat transfer coefficient for hot fluid, which is convective heat transfer coefficient of the hot water, which is stored in the water tank, that is H1. That is H1, that is 2850. So from this, so 95 minus T1 is equal to 0.2791. From this T1 is equal to 95 minus 0.2791. That is equal to 94.7 degrees centigrade. That's why you are using your temperature difference. That's why directly you can take the degree centigrade. Or otherwise, only single temperature is used, you have to convert it into Kelvin. Okay, T1. Here 94.7 degrees centigrade. And but we require T2. So second bit, you have to calculate temperature at the outside surface of the tank. That is T2. But how do you calculate? Once you calculate T1, so in between T1 and T2, so there is a conduction heat transfer. So you can use the Fourier slop heat conduction. So Q is small Q is equal to per unit area, Q is Ka, so that is 1 unit, 1 meter square. That's why small Q is equal to K into delta T, change in temperature divided by thickness L, delta T by D, delta X, or DT by DX. So DX here, your thickness L, implies from this temperature draw, temperature change, delta T is equal to Q into L by K from this relation. So delta T is equal to Q into L divided by K. From this temperature drop, delta T is equal to Q 795.308 into thickness of the material here, thickness. We are conduction, we are following the Fourier's law of heat conduction equation. So thickness 12 mm. So 12 mm into 10 power minus 3, you have to convert into meters, divided by K. Divided by K, where K is the thermal conductor of the mild steel, a tank material, tank wall material, that is given as 50. That's why delta T, that T1, T1 minus T2 is calculated as 0.19. So T1 minus T2 is 0.19. From this you can calculate T2, but already you know the T1 value. Substitute the T1 value here and calculate T2. So from this 94, T1 value 94.7 minus T2 is equal to 0.19. From this, T2 is equal to around 94.5 degrees centigrade. So temperature of the wall, outside wall surface, T2, 94.5 degrees centigrade. Here, T2 temperature at the outside of the tank or wall surface, outside wall surface. So T2 is 94.5 degrees centigrade. That's why this is very important. Sometimes you have to combine the convection, conduction, again one more convection, sometimes convection and conduction, sometimes two convections and one conduction, like that. That is known as combined heat transfer, combined mode of heat transfer. Already given in the yesterday, how do you calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient? If you combine convection and conduction. Okay, one problem I solved here, but all of you so solve other problems available. Okay, next topic. So we have completed so far. Okay. So radial systems. Radial systems. So radial systems, there are two types. We have completed the problems under composite wall and that combined transfer wall. So composite wall, we have more than two materials. Only if you consider conduction, we saw two problems yesterday. And if you combine convection and conduction for the wall, any wall, single plane wall or composite wall. So we have solved one problem for single plane wall by combining convection, conduction, and second convection. And next, radial systems. When the heat is transferred, heat transfer takes place through radial systems like cylinders and spheres. Generally, there are two important radial systems. So universal syllabus has given cylinders and spheres. So whenever heat transfer takes place within the cylinder, how do you calculate heat transfer rate? Heat transfer rate Q, small q, it is along the radius. Heat is inside radius Ri, small Ri. So if you consider a cylinder of inside radius Ri, outside radius Ro, O for outside, I for inside, and length of the cylinder L, inside temperature Ti, outside temperature To, outside temperature To. So heat transfer along the radius. Here we are calculating the heat transfer along the radius, one direction, along the radial direction. So by neglecting in the other two directions. So consider a cylinder having inside radius Ri, outside radius Ro, and inside temperature Ti, this is Ti, outside temperature To, and heat transfer along the radius, small q, heat transfer rate per unit area. So small AR, heat transfer rate is along the radius Q. Okay, na? And length of the cylinder L. For this, you consider a small elemental volume at a distance R from the center of the cylinder. So cylinder, we are analyzing a cylinder heat transfer. So radial system, there are two radial systems, cylinder and sphere. First, we will discuss today cylinder. Tomorrow, we'll go for sphere. So here, consider a cylinder of length L, and it is, you are supplying heat transfer rate Q, and inside radius Ri, outside radius Ro, and inside this hollow cylinder, for example, hollow cylinder, inside radius Ri, outside radius Ro, and inside temperature Ti, outside temperature To. And for this heat transfer analysis, consider a small elemental volume at a distance r, small r, from the center, and thickness dr, this thickness dr. Consider a long cylinder of inside radius ri, outside radius ro, this outside radius ro, and length of the cylinder L, and a temperature difference. Generally, if heat at the center and temperature inside temperature is more than that of the outside temperature. That's why temperature difference is Ti minus To. Ti minus To. The direction of heat flow is along the radius of the cylinder. The direction of the heat flow is along the radius of the cylinder, that is along the radius R, that is R. So the direction of the heat flow is along the radius of the cylinder, that is R. Next, here also, because we are conduction heat transfer, we are considering conduction heat transfer through the material, through the solid material of the cylinder. So here also, we have to consider the Fourier's law of heat transfer, Fourier's law of heat conduction. Here, for this small elemental volume at a distance r, small r, from the center of the cylinder, of thickness dr, So area of the heat flow, for this small element. So this is, for example, at a distance r, so the area, so heat transfer flowing like this from this circle to this thickness dr, area 2 pi r. 2πr into for a length of L. So surface area for the surface area like this 2πr that is into L. So surface area of the heat flow AR 2πr pi dL or 2πr L. So at a distance R from the center and if you can length of the cylinder L and total surface area so 2πr into L. So heat transfer rate Q along the radius R is equal to minus Ka dT by dx, temperature drop and thickness. So QR is equal to minus K into AR 2πr L. That's why 2 minus 2πk R into L into dT by dR. So variation of temperature along the small radius, change of radius dr, dt, small dt by small dr. So minus k here dt by dx. Here dx is here, this one. So along the radius, the small differential thickness dr. So minus 2pi k r l into dt by dr. So what are the variables here? So variables. Radius and temperature. So temperature. So change in radius, change in the temperatures. So the variables are radius and temperature. That's why, so separate the variables from the differentiation concept. Separate the variables. So QR, 1 by R, you take the radius left side. Take the radius left side, QR by R, and take the DR to the left side into DR. So QR by R into DR is equal to minus 2pi K L into DT by integrating. So QR, so take outside for given heat transfer rate QR. So other constant, take constant and take QR outside into 1 by R DR by integrating integral of 1 by R DR. What is the integral of 1 by R DR? Log natural ln r log r between the limits inside radius ri, here radius along the radius, inside radius ri, outside radius ro. So ln r after integration ln r, but what are the limits here? Ri to ro, inside radius ri, outside radius ro, that is equal to minus 2pi constant k for a given value of thermal conductivity of material of the cylinder K into L, length of the cylinder. That is also given length constant. But integral of dt from so Ti to To. So integral after integration, integral dt then T. So you have to substitute the limits from To minus Ti. So limits, so Ti to To, or after substituting limits, this is minus 2pi KL To minus Ti. So after simplification, QR into LN RO by RI, LN RO minus LN RI, LN RO minus LN RI. After simplification, ln ro by ri, ln ro by ri. So qr, heat transfer rate along the radius qr into ln ro by ri is equal to, so if you remove the minus sign here, 2 pi kl instead of to minus ti, that becomes ti minus to, ti minus To. If you remove this minus sign, so this To minus Ti becomes Ti minus To. That's why QR into LN RO by RI is equal to 2 pi KL into Ti minus To. That is the equation. From this, you can calculate Q, heat transfer rate along the radius R. This derivation also very important. For a cylinder arrangement, how do you calculate heat transfer rate along the radius QR? So So from this relation, QR is equal to 2 pi KL. So TI minus TO divided by LN divided by LN RO by RI. That is the heat transfer rate. Okay, nah? Therefore, Q, heat transfer rate QR along the radius Q is equal to 2 pi, capital Q only this one, because we are considering the area. That's why instead of small Q, you have to use the capital Q. Heat transfer rate Q is equal to 2 pi KL into 2 pi KL into TI minus TO divided by LN RO by RI. And here, in the radial system of cylinder, in the cylinder, what is the thermal resistance here? So temperature potential divided by thermal resistance. Heat transfer rate Q is equal to thermal potential difference divided by the thermal resistance. The thermal resistance, what is thermal resistance here? The thermal resistance in this case, or in the cylinder case, is LN RO by RI divided by 2 pi KL. Very, very important. Thermal resistance of the cylinder, LN RO by RI divided by 2 pi KL. What is RO? Outside radius of the cylinder. What is RI? Inside radius of the cylinder. What is 2? Constant. What is pi? Constant. 3.14. What is K? Thermal conductivity of the material of the cylinder. Solid material. Thermal conductivity of the cylinder. And L is the length of the cylinder. Length of the cylinder. So, thermal electrical circuit for this cylinder arrangement. So, heat transfer Q from the temperature, initial temperature TI to TO with a thermal thermal resistance of LN RO by RI divided by 2 pi KL. Okay, na? Now, for the three layer, that is one single cylinder. For three layers of inside radius R1, R2, R3, R4. Three layers, layer one, layer two, layer three. For three layer cylinder, the cylinder system, the solution is heat transfer rate Q is equal to 2 pi L, not K here, 2 pi L into T1, overall temperature drop, T1 to the T1, T2, T3, T4, temperature inside T1. In between, the metal A, metal B, metal C. First material, this is inside radius R1, outside radius R2. For the second material, inside radius R2, outside radius R3. And for the fourth material, third material C. So inside radius R3, outside radius R4. And temperature inside T1. In between A and B, T2. In between B and C, T3. And outside surface temperature, T4. So overall temperature drop, T1 minus T4. Heat transfer along the radius, Q. So for this, heat transfer rate Q is equal to, for this, so three layer system of cylinders, for the three layer cylinder, see the solution is Q is equal to, heat transfer rate Q is equal to 2 pi L into overall temperature of T1 minus T4 divided by the resistance offered by the first material A, LN R2 by R1 divided by K, A for material A, first layer, first material A, K, A, this is K, A only. Here K, for single material 2 pi K directly can take, because for one material, but three materials, so L, 2 pi L into overall temperature drop, T1 minus T4 divided by resistance offered by the first material A, LN R2 by R1 divided by KA, and plus LN R3 by R2 divided by KB, plus LN R4 divided by R3 divided by KC. So yeah, so all the three metals are in series A, B, C. E transfer rate along the through the radius. That's why all the three metals are in series. That's why resistance offered by the metal A, Ln R2 by R1 divided by Ka. And resistance offered by the material B. So Ln R3 by R2 divided by KB plus resistance offered by material C, that is Ln R4 by R3 divided by KC. Same analysis. If there are more than three also, you can apply the same analysis. So then more radiuses. So here three materials A, B, C. If fourth material D, material E, material F, like that. Okay, na? So 2 pi ln T1 minus T4 divided by ln R2 by R1 divided by Ka plus ln R3 by R2 divided by KB plus ln R4 by R3 divided by KC. So if you combine these three materials, because all are in three series, that's why you have to add the resistance offered by material A plus resistance offered by material B plus resistance offered by the material C. Because all the three are in series, that's why R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Resistance offered by material A plus resistance offered by the material B plus resistance offered by the material C. But this system is along the radius for the cylinder having a length L. So having a cylinder length L, 2 pi L, T1, overall temperature from drop from T1 to T4. So like that, so this is a, if the number of layers are there, for a cylinder system, you can calculate transfer rate by using this formula. And corresponding electrical circuit from T1 to T4. So corresponding electrical circuit, resistance offered by material RA and T1, T2, T3, T4. First material in between T1 and T2. Resistance offered is RA. But how do you calculate resistance RA? Ln R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KAL here. So you can take this one 2 pi KA, 2 pi KAL. So resistance offered by material A, 2 pi Ln R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KAL. So you can write this. You can write this equation as T1 minus T4, T1 minus T4 divided by Ln R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KAL plus Ln R3 by R2 divided by 2 pi KBL plus Ln R4 by R3 divided by 2 pi KCL. But 2 pi L is common. That's why I've taken top 2 pi L, common term. Yeah, common term here. That's why I taken 2 pi L top. Instead of that, you can write this equation as Q is equal to, so T1 by T4 divided by Ln R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KAL plus Ln R3 by R2 divided by 2 pi KBL plus Ln R4 by R3 divided by 2 pi KCL. Okay, na? So now for this three layer system of cylinder, and it is transferred along the radius Q, and you can represent with the help of thermal circuit also. So T1 to T2, T2 to T3, T3 to T4, overall drop from T1 to T4. For the first material, resistance offered RA. How do you calculate resistance offered by the material A? Ln R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KAL. And RB, resistance offered by the material B in between T2 to T3, that is Ln R3 by R2 divided by 2 pi KBL. And resistance offered by the material C, Ln R4 by R3 divided by 2 pi KCL. Okay, na? and all the three are in series. That's why overall thermal resistance you can calculate by adding all these three. And overall heat transfer rate Q is equal to T, overall temperature drop T1 minus T4 divided by so first resistance ln R2 by R1, R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KL plus ln R3 by R2 divided by 2 pi KBL plus ln R4 by R3 divided by 2 pi KCL, where KA is the thermal conductivity of the material A, where KB is the thermal conductivity of the material B, KC is the thermal conductivity of the material C. Like that, if you combine three materials and here you can heat transfer, and here one problem is also there. So for combining, after combining three layers or one layer, two layers, so here two layers problem. Okay, anyhow, so we'll discuss in a clear cut manner this problem. All of you read the problem and get the solution for the, by using this formula. So all of you read already. I'll give the lecture 8 and lecture 9 material. I'll share in the group, and you all of you solve this problem at home. Otherwise, we'll discuss tomorrow. But what is the problem? A thick walled tube here. A thick walled tube, first material, stainless steel of thermal conductivity K is equal to 90 watts per meter Kelvin with 2 centimeters inner diameter and 4 centimeters outer diameter. OD is covered with a 3 centimeter layer of asbestos insulation. So here first material steel, outer material, second material asbestos insulation of thermal conductivity 0.2 watt per meter Kelvin. If the inside temperature, wall temperature of the pipe is maintained at 600 degree centigrade and outside temperature is 100 degree centigrade, so overall temperature drop T1 minus T2, so 600 minus 100 calorie heat loss per meter length. You're not given the length of the tube, so per calculate heat loss per meter, also calculate tube insulation interface temperature. All of you, so this is the steel material, this insulating material. All of you read the problem and analyze and solve. So if you having any doubt, we'll discuss this problem tomorrow or next class. Okay. So with this, I am stopping because you're having the fourth hour also. Nah? So any doubt? So that's all for today. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, I'll close. So thank you for your patience hearing. Any doubt? So that's all for today.